Hello there, everyone. This is I am Mark 3, and welcome back to Kerbal Space Program, where I have the lofty goal of making it more than a mile from the launch pad, which I've just upgraded so I can afford to have heavier rockets on it. Because we need to go further. Yes. Also, this rocket design is apparently slightly flawed by the fact it has very little fuel, so. We don't need these parts on it anymore. So let's go ahead and strip that out. So back to our basic pod, which we also determined at the end of last time only requires two chutes to land safely on the surface of Kerbin. So that's all well and good. Right, I picked out a couple of extra contracts for us though. We are going to be doing some hauling contracts. Have the Mark 16 parachute, which is the nose one. There, so apparently we're going to have an extra parachute anyway. Extra safety and all that. And also have a hammer solid fuel booster. And we have to haul that 19,000 meters up into the air. Apparently. So you know what we're going to do? I think we're going to go purely rocket based on this one. We need to make sure that we don't do anything too wrong. So let's go ahead and get some stuff in. Let's get a couple of decouplers on the sides of the craft. Yep, then we'll add some really big beefy boosters because, you know, more power is the answer to everything. We are okay. 26. We got four left, and I'm actually going to add in a quartet of winglets to. Just as long as it stays on four. It goes back to two every time I accidentally mouse over on the side boosters. It's a bit of annoying. But yeah, we're going to have some winglets here to help keep our flight a bit more stable. So that should be a bit better. And we've also got these massive boosters which will provide our initial lift. And we just have to get the other boosters up into the appropriate altitude, I believe. So that should be good. In theory. He says, fingers crossed. I'm a rocket man. I'm a rocket man, yes. I'm a rocket man. I know what I'm doing. Except for the fact I absolutely don't. Right. Oh, it's been too long since I played this. I am so incredibly rusty. I am, however, learning to close my landing gear before launch. So, you know, there's signs of progress, at least, you know. Now these contracts should auto-complete as soon as I hit altitude and speed requirements, I think. But yeah, slowly turn a little bit at least, so we're going this way. Oops. More power. More power did it. There's no aerodynamics on the top of the boosters though, so that's causing a few issues, but that's causing some drag. Also, I'm going way too fast as well, which also doesn't help. Oh wow, we got him way too fast. Whoops. Altitude's good. Okay, we just need to slow down a little bit. Okay. Yeah, we're still going up at over as many, many hundreds of. Yeah. How's our resources? We're low on electricity because we're using electricity for our reaction wheels, so. Let's crew report. Keep that. We've got some science to do as we drift upwards into space. We might actually get suborbital on this one. That was a massive boost from those guys. Keep that. And I think we're going to have to use our booster to cancel out a lot of downward velocity. Log temperature from upper atmosphere. Yeah, we are. Oh, we're on the. We almost went suborbital. Very nearly went suborbital. Because I just looked at the atmosphere bar. We're on the very brink of orbital with that boost we had. Ooh. Also, I can turn off the. I'll turn off the stuff that's using power. Because I'm nice like that. I'm just going to point it that way so I can get some a bit of distance, you know. So we go places with our little spice plane. A little spice plane. Still going upwards, though. Are we actually suborbital now? Are we still upper atmosphere? Yeah, we're still upper atmosphere. I looked at it, but I think I can spit behind my recording display. Yeah, I see it ticking downwards. All right. I've kind of angled like this so I can try to move that away, like forwards. But I've still got this booster to fire, of course. The problem is we're actually accelerating now. So I kind of want to get it angled up a little bit like that. This craft is not, despite having the wings, this craft is not built for gliding. Oh, nope, now we're going backwards a little bit. This way. Yeah, we want to get a bit of drag, a bit of lift, come on. But unfortunately, I don't think the gyro force is. Yeah, we don't have the gyro force or the aerodynamic control to try and control this thing. Firing the booster is probably going to wind up in a disaster if we do that. We're at the right place. Boosters! Oh no, eject! Oh god, no. Error, error! Mission of critical! Abort! Release the things! Please say I didn't just. Oh. Ugh. Brace, brace, open. Well, that failed. We didn't have anything like the control. Oh dear. We didn't have anything like the control needed to, you know, actually do that. So that was a massive failure. The rockets were too good, as it turns out. On the bright side, though, we actually got a bunch of data. We actually made it up to upper atmosphere levels. So, you know, that's good. But we didn't have the throttle control to actually do what we were meant to do. Which is not so good. Oh my. Okay. Right. Back to the Space Center. We still not made it more than a mile from the pad. I would just like to point that out. You know? We're only over there. But because we reached high altitude, we actually got a massive amount of science. We receive so much science, we can actually do some serious research. We can get science junior pods, experimental storage units, radiators, and a bigger, better antenna. Battery, though, is a kind of an important one. No sign of the solar panels, though. Where's the solar? Is that in electricity? Ah, yes, that is under electricity. Okay. But we've got batteries and things now, so we've got a few more bits and we've got a few more toys that we can try to fit onto a rocket. So that was actually kind of a horrible performance. So, take off the boosters. Let's take off. Let's move these things around a little bit. Right, let's put the ejectors there. I'll put on a pair of wings. A pair of ejectors. And this time for better... Actually, no, you know what? Do it like that, yeah. Then let's do it vertical. Let's do it vertical stacking. Let's install a battery pack. Pair of battery packs inside the cockpit area. So there we go. That will give us some more battery charge, at least. But we will, instead of doing anything stupid... Wait, this is me we're talking about. Don't mind me. Instead of doing anything stupid. What was I thinking? Jeez. Yeah, I'm going to do a vertical coupler connected to regular rockets. So we have perfect control as we go, you know? So double fuel tank along with a swivel engine, because we're going to need some, well, are we going to need some control there? What's the ISP on those? Thrust, 205. We'll get better performance out of the Reliant, but we won't get roll control kind of thing going on. So that one's there. That's the boost needs to be on manual. Okay, that'll do. Sure. I guess. I guess that'll do. That's exactly what you hear from a rocket engineer. Yeah, I guess that'll do. SAS, RCS. The SAS is my only attitude control at all. Let's go ahead and get up here. I think we're going to have to go for efficiency though, aren't we? Oops, slow it down a little bit. So yeah, we start experiencing major drag if we go above about 100, so... In the interest of conserving fuel, if I recall correctly, I don't know if this is very outdated information, but in the interest of conserving fuel, you want to maintain like 100 until you reach about 14 kilometers atmosphere. Sorry, 14 kilometers up. Do I need to do? I don't need to activate. I just need to have it at the requirements, don't I? Yeah, as the atmosphere thins, we're actually getting speed up, despite how low the rocket is, and actually the rocket is almost out. Ah! We actually achieved that contract. Good. Right. Which means we need to do this contract, then. We need to get 19 kilometers. I have no idea how high we are. Hopefully this will get us up there. Though we did just dump our other assembly straight back down onto the launch pad, so... Hopefully that's not going to bite us. Come on, don't roll. You're okay. Keep on going. We need to get the altitude up. The booster is out. We can't eject it. We need it. Oh, we're at the altitude. Oh, we made it to the altitude, but we were going too quickly. Way too quickly, which means we're probably going to be too quickly as we come back down, which is even better. Oh, another failed one. Oh, well. Didn't do too badly, though, all considered. Right. Mm-hmm. What I really need is, like, some of these guys with the ability to... With attitude control in the mix, you know? I think that's what I really need. I'm still, I don't know, just steadily rising up in what's left of my vehicle. I don't think I'm going to get the other contract, though. That is actually a tough one. Music. Space music. Open the bays. Conduct the science. Let the science commence. We are in suborbit. Yep, in space near Kerbin. Oh, yes, another important milestone. So we can get all the data. Yes, indeed. I mean, just getting this back down to the surface is going to be worth plus 12 science points. So, you know, really nice. And a crew report from here. It seems like we're very much in space right now. The sky seems to be mostly below us, which is worth 5. Crew reports aren't worth very much, but... You know what I forgot to do? I forgot to include a junior science module on this trip. Oh, well, we're dropping back down, though. We're dropping pretty quick. Pretty quick. I don't know where we're going to land, though. Oops, daisy. Oh, we're starting to encounter atmosphere. Yep, our RCS is overloaded. Okay, might as well just... Oh, yeah, I already spent it. Whoops. Oh, well, there's no way we were going to get that anyway. Because we're already way above the speed it requires. So I think we need to... Oh, no, we're at risk of burning up. Right, deploy the air brakes! I'm falling sideways. That's not ideal. Oh, well, at least with the gear out, I've got a bit more drag going on. But this craft is not well designed for landing... safely. I'm actually slightly concerned right now. Okay, good. We've slowed down enough for the center of mass. The center of mass is pretty neutral in this guy, though. But, like, I can't... I literally can't tell how low we are. So I'm just going to try and slow us down a bit more. I think we're about 1 point something. You guys can see the altitude control. I can't. Oh, yeah, there we go. Right, deploy! Main chutes, go! Whew. Where's my rocket piece? Oh, there it is, about 8... Here it comes, very slowly. Oh well, we got major science though, we made it into orbit. And that's nothing new, okay. So that piece of debris is going to catch up with us at some point. Actually no, it's going to land somewhere over there. Okay. this is one of the problems with this game though, it's like I just have to wait while I slowly drift down towards my landing. Yep, that piece just splashed down rather hard. I think it's going to be scrap metal at this point, really. Here we go. Splash. Now, am I in the coast or am I in the ocean? I think that's the key question here. From the water. The goo escapes into the water. The goo is free. We have contaminated the world's oceans. No, that's the one I used before. View data on this one. Log pressure data. So we're getting some extra science because we managed to go far enough to actually go to a place. How's our resources? Electric charge is absolutely fine. Okay. Crew report. Cancel that. Review my data. This crew report. Let's transmit it. Seeing as we want to do that. So sent that, and then we can grab an additional crew report from where we are for an additional 2 science. We can also do an EVA to add an EVA report for this place, which is worth another 3 science. So we're just nickel and diming really for the science, but I think we're going to get a bunch of this one because we actually made it into orbit. Well, we made it into space. Not orbit, mind you, just space. So that's something. But we got a lot of science for that one, so we should be able to get some more toys, in theory. Let's see, we should be over... There we are, on the horizon. We made it further than a mile. We're more than a mile, so objective for this particular episode is achieved. We cover that, and we get 86 science. Oh yeah, that is nice. We got science for days. Science for days. I can now add solar panels and things like that, because that is only worth 90. Oh wait, I can't get that. That's worth 90. Blast it. Maybe I should just get some, well, some advanced, bigger fuel tanks would be good for the rockets. Admittedly. But so some extra bits and pieces would be quite nice. But we can afford any one tech. Crew cabin's not needed. Decouplers, structural fuselage. And adapters. Oh well. Anyway, it's end of this part though. So, this has been IMark3. Thank you all very much for watching. I hope you guys are enjoying the show. And I will catch you all some other time. Yes, indeed. See you all later.